Hello and welcome back to the Link to the Past Randomizer. It's episode 3. I'm still in the light world. Haven't progressed too much. I do have the hookshot though, so that's a plus. Look, I could zip across here if there was anything there within reach, which there isn't. But if there was, I could. Like here, where again there isn't, but if there was, I could. I'm heading to the Eastern Temple. As my first visit there, frankly, a little bit too rapid, wasn't it? You know, I didn't quite cross all the I's, nor did I dot all the T's. For all like, the thing is, I don't know which situation will make me more smug. If I go in here, go crack open those last few chests, and there's nothing, or if I go in here, and it's like something huge, like the Master Sword, or I don't know if you can actually get the Master Sword, but the hammer, maybe. Christ, I've just thought about that. What if I give my sword to the dwarves, and in return they don't give me a sword back, they give me like an apple? That'd be pretty funny, actually. To be honest, in this sort of extravaganza, it's the most one could hope for. Back once again. Didn't even look if they were dead. Right, so let's think about this logically. I can't. I'm just going to go for the right door. I don't know why, every time I do this dungeon, which is a lot, I always go through that left door first. I don't think you have to in any way. It's just I always do. Good shit in there. Nope, just good shit in the first one. Aha, right. Okay, that's fine. That's vindication one way. But I think there might be one more chest. I think it's down there, if there is one. Look how fast I can move. Isn't it glorious? There's certainly no way of having to do this dungeon with a hookshot, but I don't think you can have done it and had the boots first, can you? I don't know what triggers these guys spawning in, because at first I thought they just did it after time. But when I was here last time, they took ages, and they didn't do it until I got near the door. But then this time, they just came pretty much straight away. So I don't know, is the answer. I don't want to know, particularly. Unless it's interesting, which it probably won't be. That's a way out, isn't it? Yeah, because I skipped out, like, the entire room where there's, like, the, there's some of the spinny things, and it's where you get the master key. That's crux. And there's this room, there's some darkness, there's jellies in here. Yeah, so in here you get the key by doing something or other, and then you go back in there. That's some pretty expert killing, isn't it? That's when you can kill several skeletons just by throwing a pot at each of them. That's a man not to be trifled with. The real key is the bit that gives you the master key, the big key, master key, big key, boss key. It's in here, and it doesn't require a what's it called. Is it a chest, or does it just drop from the ceiling? It must be a chest, because I got it from a chest. In fact, it has to be something, because I've already got the damn master key. Alright. Don't panic. Just scratching my nose. Perfectly normal thing to do. And fucking shovel. Alright, I'm so glad I came back here, because right, the shovel, not that useful, but it could have been something else. And I'm pretty sure that's it for this area now. I'm also pretty sure there's no quick way out of here, is there? I have to go back through the whole dungeon. So I haven't got the fucking magic mirror yet. The mirror, that might be an item set in place. Otherwise, you end up going to the Dark World and you can't get out. That might be what I was thinking of. Before I said the moon pearl that didn't do anything, but I... It's one of those. Either the mirror's where it always is, or the moon pearl doesn't do anything. Shit, I can't remember. I think it might be that you don't need the moon pearl. Or you... Doesn't matter, I'm out of here now. I've got the shovel, which would have actually genuinely been useful last episode when I was trying desperately to find money, because in my head, digging is like the most efficient way of getting money. When you're just in a place and you need to do it quickly, certainly. Now, the good thing about the shovel is, normally, you get the shovel in the dark world from the flute kid who gets turned. However, you use it in the light world to dig up his flute. So I can just go to where his flute is, because I know that, and dig up his treasure. This is the wrong area. But that's good I came here anyway, because I want to go in this cave. Okay. Didn't need any of this, that's fine. For some reason, I had it as that shop being in this building over here. Despite the fact that clearly this isn't it. This is a fortune teller? It is. Love that song. You know what, I'm going to go back in there because, you know, the beat drops and she comes in with the high-pitched bit. Come on, give it to me. Just when you're getting used to it. Just when it's getting stale. There it is. Okay. But, no. It's so good of them to put those fucking people in these games. When I say those fucking people, I don't mean gypsy fortune tellers. They're on a hard building, they're not gypsies. Gone down an odd path here. Fortunately, most gypsies can't use computers. What am I doing? Yeah, let's just go and dig up what could potentially be a flute, but probably isn't. The really annoying thing is, I'm pretty sure I know the exact location the thing will be buried. And I'm pretty sure it's in this patch of daisies at the top left. However, if I've got that wrong, okay, that's fine. Now, interestingly, because this is based off A Link to the Past, the original-ish version, you can't have the flute and the shovel at the same time. So, if I get the flute at some random interval, my shovel will just evaporate. Yeah, I gotta go to Death Mountain. That's my only real course of action at this point. How am I gonna get there? I don't think I can get there from this place, but there is something up here. That's an alternate route into the castle. There's something here. I think it's fairies beneath these rocks, but I will just check. Oh, my face is so itchy. It is. And until I get a net, those are only so useful to me. A net will give me a bug-catching device, you see. She's a very helpful woman. Little Benny Hill joke there from... God knows when. I don't even know how old Benny Hill is. No, you don't know who Benny Hill is. You know his theme tune, that's it. Yeah, so Death Mountain. There's nothing actually stopping me going up Death Mountain, is there? I feel like you might need the gloves to sort of start your journey up there, but even that I'm not 100% on. It's surprisingly open. A lot of this, the first map. A lot of the dungeons you can't get in, like you need the Book of Midori, whatever, to get into the desert dungeon. And then you need the Pegasus Boots to get that, but you need to have done the first dungeon first. But, this early bit. Okay, now you do need to have lifted the big rock. It's because when I was worse at the game, you know, and things would take longer and you'd be bad, sometimes you'd get the item for a dungeon, but not complete the dungeon. You'd save that for another day. So you might end up exploring the map with like the gloves, but not the pendant. Hey buddy, do you want the lift? Yeah, sure, I'll help you. It's just this way. Oh, I'm so scared of the dark. Won't you help me? Yeah, sure. I feel like I'm not supposed to run with him in tow. Yep. Take the path to the left or right? I think it's left. Nope. I look like a right dick now. The guy just goes, oh, I'll go right here, and I immediately went left. Hey, we're nearly at my home. It's this one with the cool little porch. Here it is. Thanks. I think he's the third wise man. Okay, magic pouch. So my theory about the mirror being in a set location was incorrect. Which does mean that we're going to find out something interesting later on when I try and use that and I can't. One of the better parts of the hookshot is that enemies it kills in such a satisfying way because it just brutalizes them. I don't know if there's anything actually in here. I think this might just be nothing, to be honest. Weirdly large basement this guy's got. I know I'd been there before, but I had a vague feeling that there might have been something underneath. Look at that, I've skipped out a huge part of this area. Not really. Fuck off. Fucking hate those enemies. For some reason, they're even more annoying, like, in later games they appear in. Oh no, the bridge is broken. How will I get across? Okay, I'm across. I gotta be careful now, because I'm in a higher level area. Like, these enemies are quite strong. And they will kill me. So down here, one of these will give me a heart, surely. Really? Bit harsh. Yeah, that in these caves, there's a whole bunch of rooms, like treasure chests and shit. So there's a real solid chance there's something useful down there. Christ. See how that nearly killed me then? I'm gonna drink the potion. That's fine. Note it pauses the game when you take that. And it pauses it for the length of time it takes to restock the thing that you're restocking. So when you've got a whole bunch of hearts, that can actually take quite a bit of time. I'm also fully aware that there's fairies kicking around in one of these caves. I think there's a little shop in here, isn't there? The most inexplicably located item shop in the world. Oh no. Might be in the dark world. Great. Could that have actually been more pointless just then? It would have struggled, wouldn't it? Is this the one I think's a shop? No. Ah. Oh. This is so annoying. How am I going to trigger that? Have I got something that will do it? See, this is where you want the boomerang. You can cheese shit with it. Technically, this hits everything on screen, but it doesn't affect that. The man who is ever so careful with everything he has just fucking used a medallion for no point. But we know those are there. That's good. And we know that the confirmation, which I believe is the right use of that word, of the floor blocks has to be the opposite of whatever it is now. I knew there was a fucking shop here somewhere. I'm not going crazy. And I was right about it being in a ridiculous location. So if by some... Now, I don't know if that item... those ever-changing blocks, if that's instanced per for the whole game world, or if it's like per dungeon or sort of per set. I honestly can't remember. I already know this is a dead end, don't I? Yeah. little cheat of the hookshot in this game is when you're using it, you're completely invincible. So always aim big with it, because even if you miss, whilst it's out, you can't take any damage. There was actually nothing of any real use over there. There were two chests, but I got nothing from them. But there could have been something in them. There wasn't, but there could have been. So now I've got to head further up Death Mountain. And I'm going to be honest, I am kind of at the point where I might have to cheat. And by cheat, I mean that when I made this randomized seed, that it gives you a list of spoilers of as to where everything is. 100 rupees up there. Normally there'd be a heart piece. Feel like I should drop down this area. Would have been too much, wouldn't it? Now, there's a bunch of fairies here. Come to me. Come to daddy. Can't think where this actually leads. Is it just outside? Down the mountain? No. Nowhere super useful. But yeah, it's good to go over these things. Because that's the thing. If I was in, I'm just going to complete the game mode, I know, you know, what stuff can be avoided and what can be, what should be gained. I love this. The fact that you can see the trees below, it makes you feel like you are crazy high up. Even though, you know, you're not. Think there's something in here. Think it's normally a piece of heart. Or could be anything. It's 50 rupees, we've already seen it. And it was a piece of heart. I can't actually remember what advice he gives you there. Now, before I go into the portal, I am going to save it. Because I might not be able to leave otherwise. And it could prove the end of this entire attempt. I'm also starting to doubt my theory early on that every seed can be completed. Right, so is there anything else up here? No. I don't think there's any point to dropping down there. Right, I'm going to save it. Which is actually very easy, because it's a one of these things. Just saving slot 2 there. Pretty sure that worked. Let's get that off screen. Okay, right. So, the moon pearl is necessary. I don't have the mirror. I cannot leave this place. Ever. What's in here? Is it just a thing you can hammer? Oh no, fairy portal. Oh, you're so adorable, is what she's probably thinking. Not just a rabbit he turns into, but a fucking pink rabbit. And he keeps his tunic on, which to be fair is quite adorable. I know there's nothing here. It's crazy when you first get this bit, because like it just comes out of nowhere, and you think, oh, is this like a one-off thing? And then if you think to check the world map, it's like, hang on, this is the same but clearly different. It's not just like a shaded-in version. It's like, is there a whole nother world? Why is it called A Link to the Past? Shouldn't it be called A Link Between Worlds? But then they use that again later. Were there two worlds in that? Must have been. I don't want to come back up here. I'm stuck. This is it. Game over. I can go in here, but unless I had a hammer that I could use, it's pointless. Normally, I have got the magic cape to get me through that. I'm going to reload. Load game position, load position 2. Look, here we are, we're back again. That is so useful. Right, so unless I get the mirror or the moon pearl, I cannot continue up here. I do think I do have two options, though. I'm gonna hide in this house. I think he heals you. He does. I thought he did. He's good like that. You know, he might not have given me the magic mirror he was supposed to. In fact, I can't quite remember what he gave me. It might have been like 10 rupees. Or was it a piece of heart? Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. I have got options here. There's two things I'm pretty sure I can do. Whoops. Hell of a set down that. Trying to leave Death Mountain is not actually that easy. And I've just realised, I've remembered how you do it now. This is the wrong cave. You have to go in a cave that it actually has a sign outside it saying this way down from Death Mountain. Those boulders are so cool. Such a cool effect. It's this cave here. Yeah. Pretty sure I can just run out of it. Oh, nearly fell. Would have been disastrous. Ah, damn it. You gotta turn the run off right at the end, otherwise you slam into the hole. But it saves you so much time. Shit, forgot to do it again. Alright, I won't get greedy this time. Okay, imagine if that bat had knocked me into the hole. And here we are, back where we started. I wonder if, because I've been to the Dark World, no, they're still there. Guys, I need you to fuck off. The fate of the world literally rests in what is below your tree. Yeah, what I never actually attempted to do is, I can't remember if you actually need anything in it. There's one of two changes that I can't remember. It's either you can immediately get the Master Sword, or you can immediately just cut the... There's a crab in there. He's dead. Or you can immediately cut open the... there's 300 rupees there. Sweet. Oh, I can just go and get it. Nice. Or you can immediately slash the magic binding thing at the top of the Hyrule Castle. It's one or the other, but I can't remember what. I think that might be it, but we'll see if it's this. No. Okay. Okay. Okay, it's worth a try. I was going to say that's not Japanese anymore. It actually looks Egyptian. It's supposed to be Hylian. I'm now curious. Is the Japanese Hylian text different to the English Hylian text? I feel like it is. I'm not curious enough to like go and learn Hylian or whatever. It's the master feel... So, wait, no, this doesn't feel quite right. I don't know why they did that, put those little fake master swords in there. It's funny. It's a great dick move. And I'll be honest, in my youth, I did go in there because, like, if you don't just explore around on your own, you probably won't go to this area before you have to. And you just get told, yeah, the master sword's there. Go grab it, and you just walk in, and it's like, oh, there it is. I guess I'll have it. Am I forgetting something in this area? Is there a chest in their house, maybe? Didn't think there was. Hey, old medicine woman. Ray, how are you? How's your father? Oh, dead, you see. Well, that old man in the east might be able to help. I'll mark it on your map for you. Bye! Yep. It's kind of an optional little thing. You can go to this village to kind of learn the game a bit. Yeah, okay. Okay. Nope, don't want to do that. Nope, don't want to do that. I want to do this. I've just realised, it doesn't say I have the pendant that I've got. Did I not pick it up? Or did it... I mean, I definitely did, didn't I? It teleported me out of the dungeon, for Christ's sake. It might just be a quirk that it's saying I don't have it. So I'm going to go to Hyrule Castle and see if I can slash my way in. I think I'll be able to. If not, I've got no idea what I'm doing next, and I'll have to look up the cheat. Which I will do in between episodes. This is the side we're in, isn't it? Yeah. I can lift this now. I'm strong as fuck. Why have I got bombs equipped? What the hell was I thinking? Does that magic powder help me do anything? No, I don't think it does it? You can use it on some enemies to gain some effect. You can use it on that kind of little demon statue. That's the main use for it. Does it do anything else? I don't think it does. Alright, so I'm already upstairs enough. I need to go outside and down. I mean, this might genuinely work now. I'm not sure. Yeah! Okay, no. Oh, no, that's it. Yeah, you have to put it on first. But yeah, you can just walk past it. How long have I had that magic cape for? How long has that been an option? Genuinely. Alright. Well, we know what we're doing now, at least. I think that might be the change they make. They make it so that either the Master Sword or the cape can get you by it. Is that it? Maybe the cape can always do that. It wouldn't surprise me. Shit. Shit. That does too little damage to attempt again. Damn it. Shit. I've got no healing items, damn it. Forget how bad I am at this game when I actually have to play it. It's alright though, the dungeon will provide. Oh god, they're fast. They're so fast. Thing is, because you're supposed to have the Master Sword, you're supposed to do double damage. Thank god that was the key. What if it wasn't? What if it just gives me a lantern? Something bullshit. I feel like there's another enemy in this room. No. Damn it. Damn it. Did that do any damage? I don't think it did. Give me a heart, you tight bastards. Now watch as I immediately lose this. Fuck it. Alright, good. You know what? Double fuck it, why not? Damn it, it just turned them to ice this time. I'm glad I wasn't going insane about thinking that they just turned enemies to ice. Fucking lasts a long time then, doesn't it? I thought that wore out pretty quickly. I might be wrong, maybe it doesn't ever wear out. Trick is, you turn them to ice, you smash them with the hammer, much higher chance of giving you little magic vial back. I'm not lost. I was kind of hoping I'd die, but that hasn't occurred. I've actually got a bit of health left, so I guess I'll probably just end the episode around here anyway. Maybe in this room. This will be a nice room to end it on. Oh god, it's a room of death. Fuck it. You don't have to see them. He said, hoping against hope. Sounded to me like this hit more than those two enemies. Thing is, there's not really any puzzles in this dungeon. I know it to be much more of a combat one. Fuck. Yeah, how'd you like that? You couldn't even give me arrows, you heartless dick. I'm hoping I don't need the Master Sword to beat the boss. Because normally you need to reflect his magic back at him. I don't have that ability. What the fuck? I definitely hit that first guy with my hookshot and it didn't do anything. We all saw it. He's there. He'll come down eventually. Fuck it. He wasn't there. He didn't come down eventually. A bomb. A bomb is a drop. It's huge. I don't know what that did. I didn't see if there was already a door closed or anything. Fucking you assholes. I hate you. Stronger than they look, these bastards. They're all the blue ones as well. That was weird, wasn't it? The music kind of got stuck. Ah, light. Glorious light. Look, they throw little tridents. It's adorable. Also, my hookshot can knock them out of the air because it's amazing. Being a bit harsh with the old hearts, isn't it? Okay, I thought he was going to throw a trident at me. Instead, he just tried to run at me. That's fine. Tell you, I just miss my boomerang. Boomerang is my go-to item in this. I'm a goddamn ninja with it. Fuck. There we go. I don't want to risk him being able to hurt me over that low pedestal. Okay, right. Some of these will be hearts. Surely. Surely. Sure. There we go. There we go. One fucking heart in the bunch. I should end the episode. You know what? I will. I'll end the episode here. A bit of excitement. Start with maybe a boss next time. So that was part three. Thanks for watching. Join me next time for more. I'll see you then.